Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In this series we started discussing deduplication engines. In our previous video, we covered how to run space reclamation. In this video, we will continue discussing the other options. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. From all tasks, we have already discussed these options. Advanced menu has one option, add partitions. Use this option to add more partitions to an existing online deduplication database that is used by a storage policy enabled with deduplication. For example, you can change a single DDB configuration to a two-partitioned, or a four-partitioned DDB, or two-partitioned DDB configuration, to a three-partitioned, or a four-partitioned DDB. Configure additional partitions window. Before you add partition, make sure that the destination media agent is of same operating system type as of source media agent. When configuring additional partitions to the DDB, if any data protection job is running to the storage policy, then the data protection job will go to pending state and resumes as per the job restart interval. Number of partitions. Select the number of partitions that you want to add to an existing DDB. As the note says, jobs running to this DDB will be interrupted during this add partition operation. Partition displays the number of partitions that already exist. Media agent and partition path displays the selected media agent and the path location of the DDB partition. DDB network interface. By default, it picks the default interface on the media agent. You can define dedicated network interface name for each partition media agent. Click Choose Path. Partition Path window. Media agent. Select the existing media agent from the list. Partition Path. Browse and select the location of the DDB partition. In advanced, you have VSS cow volume drive to host the snapshot created by the DDB backup process using VSS copy on write method. Normally it uses the default location, that is the drive hosting the DDB, but if you wish to change the location, then you have option to browse and select the location that hosts the snapshot of the drive where the DDB is hosted. Once done, click OK. Click OK, so the new partition gets created. After new partitions are added to a DDB, on running backups, the signatures are distributed evenly across the partitions. New baseline for the DDB store is started each time a new partition is added, and some of the same signatures might be written to the new partition, even though they exist in the DDB store. The date has aged when there are no more references to the blocks left, and then the date has pruned physically from the DDB, as well as from the magnetic disk. Lastly, from support perspective, please note these. If all go well, the new partition appears under the DDB. The next menu is View. Jobs. Jobs filter for deduplication database window. Select desired options and click OK. These are the jobs that ran on the storage policies associated with this DDB. Next option, View DDB verification jobs. Admin job history filter. Select desired options and click OK. These are the data verification jobs, that is both DV and DV1 jobs, ran for this DDB. Last one is, view DDB space reclamation jobs. We have not run it, so we do not have history of this, but if they have run, then it would look like this. Select properties. Deduplication database properties window. General tab. Deduplication database name, displays the name of the DDB. If needed, you can modify the name of the DDB. Creation time, is the date and time that the active DDB was created. Version, displays the software version of the DDB. Estimated baseline size for new DDB, is the amount of space required on the disk, for a new backup data, when the existing DDB is sealed. Number of partitions, displays the number of DDB partitions. Total application size, is the front-end data size. Total data size on disk, is the size of data written on disk, after deduplication. Deduplication savings, displays the percentage of deduplication achieved. DDB access path, displays information for each partition configured for the storage policy copy. Partition, displays the number of partitions configured for DDB. Media agent and partition, displays the name of the media agent hosting the DDB, and the DDB path. Minimum free space in MB, is the total amount of free space, that must be available all times on the disk, that is hosting the DDB. By default, the minimum free space required on the volume, to host the DDB is set to 5 GB. You can modify the amount of minimum free space from here. Please note, you cannot specify value lower than 5 GB. If the disk space size reaches below the size specified, then the DDB will be marked as offline. Backup jobs will not continue. And pruning of backed up data from disk is prevented, until the DDB is available. Therefore, the minimum free space on the volume must be maintained all the time, to avoid backup failures, and to reclaim the disk space. Free space warning in MB, will generate an event message, disk space low alert, if configured, when the amount of free space on the disk, that is hosting the DDB, falls below the specified amount. By default, the minimum free space at which an event message must be generated, is set to 10 GB. If needed, you can modify the value from here, but do note, you cannot specify value lower than 10 GB. If free space on the DDB disk falls below 10 GB threshold, the SIDB engine log displays that the zero ref journal is deleted. However, if the free space on the DDB disk crosses the high threshold of 20 GB, then the SIDB engine log displays that the zero ref journal is recreated. As the message says, you cannot move, or create, the DDB partitions from here. Settings tab. Use this tab, to configure settings for the DDB. Enable software compression with deduplication. By default, when a storage policy is configured to use deduplication, compression is automatically enabled for the storage policy copy. All the subclients associated to this storage policy will use storage policy compression settings, that is, use storage policy option is enabled on the subclient properties of all subclients associated to the storage policy. Do not deduplicate against objects older than N days is the number of days after which a unique data block cannot be used for deduplication during new data protection jobs. Setting this value ensures that very old data blocks are not allowed as the origin data for newer data protection jobs that are deduplicated. It is important to note, if you set a value for less than 30 days, Then the window will display the value, but internally it will default to 365 days. For example, if you set the value to 29 days, then the window will display 29 days, but data blocks that are as old as 365 days will be used for deduplication during new data protection jobs. Enable garbage collection is enabled by default to optimize DDB pruning by reducing the disk I/O. Enable pruning logs for reconstruction is also enabled by default to optimize the DDB reconstruction performance, wherein pruning journal is maintained that logs all the records that are removed during the pruning operation. Enable physical pruning. This option is selected by default. You can clear the checkbox to disable the physical pruning for the DDB. Order tab. Use this window to create notes about the DDB. Ordered history lists all of the notes previously entered about the DDB, including the user who entered the note, the severity, and the date that the note was entered. Use New Audit button to open the New Audit dialog box window. Once done, click OK. We will end this video here and discuss the other options in our next video. Please hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.